So this is a game on Ensk with the FV4005 Stage 2, which is a Tier 10 British tank destroyer with a 183mm gun capable of doing about 2,000 damage, but it only has about 14mm of armor in its superstructure. So anytime anyone sees this gigantic tank out on the battlefield, if you get spotted, you get prioritized and shot immediately. It doesn't reverse very quickly, so we have to be very careful of how far you advance, because it's very difficult to get out of the way and get back into cover quickly. So that's the challenge of this tank. We're on Ensk. This is a city map. It's the smallest map in the game. It only has 600 meters of distance, so that means that each grid is only 60 meters. So the distance between these windows and these windows, which is where initially I'm going to try to get shots, is only a couple of hundred meters. And so you get spotted immediately, and you have to be very careful about how exposed you are, because you can't get back into cover quick enough. One of the challenges with this tank is because it has no camouflage. Most of the maps in World of Tanks have like a high point in the middle, and you can't shoot over it. So you have to get back far enough and high enough so you can see enemy tanks in the distance, but you're still not so close that they can spot you. I'm going to initially take a position over here against this building on the corner, and these are my initial thoughts as the countdown is going down. So I'm going to go here, I'm going to try to see if there's any opportunities here, and then there's a gap between these buildings where you can line up shots, which we'll talk about. This is a relatively simple game. I basically drive around in a circle. I wind up doing 5,000 damage, so let's see how this plays out. So this Grulé immediately goes to the windows to see if he can get a shot over on the other windows on the other side. I kind of try to keep my distance and loop around and come up to this corner here. There's like a 5-second aim time on this vehicle, so you have to, you know, stay behind cover, line up your shots, and wait. I see the 121B here. I don't see anything in the windows that I can see, so I'm going to try to look around the battlefield, see what's happening out here with the enemy forces, and then see if I can't line up maybe a shot through here. But this is what I mean about this vehicle on city maps, where you kind of skulk around behind cover trying to line up shots. Again, I'm watching this play out on the minimap. I can see that enemy forces are here. The field is not much is happening yet over here. So I don't really see a shot through here yet, so I'm going to go up and see if I can't get an angle on this 121B. I come up to this building, I pre-aim into the building to try to get my reticle smaller, and then I creep forward. Nothing there. I'm playing a peek-a-boom here. I see the 121B is still in that window, so I'm going to try to stay behind this pattern and see if I can't line up a shot. So he lights me, I just fire and back up. Now I see this Fosh B has moved up to here, and my 60 TP is going up to attack him. Try to support the 60 TP in case the Fosh pulls up into view. He doesn't. I see the E100, but I don't have an angle. There's no snapshotting in this tank. So here, I see the 705A pulling up, and see if this works. I've got to go into free camera if I can. All right. Did it work? It didn't work. Hold on. Okay, so now if you see where this AMX M454 is, which is the French heavy tank, there's a pile of rocks here. And if I try to get to his perspective, I can do this. I haven't done this in a while. I'm utterly failing at it. Okay, so here, there's this pile of rocks. You can come up to here in a heavy tank and hide your lower plate and try to shoot through the gap, which is where I am on the other side, trying to do the same thing. And I see this 705 pulling up, and he exposes his the front of his tank. And when he initially pulled up, I thought I was aiming at this plate here. Now, I've already taken the shot in this video, so I had a green plus on my reticle, which meant my penetration armor was showing me that I would penetrate him. I was actually aimed down here, not here. I often shoot at this plate on the 705A because at certain angles you can penetrate him here if he's because this tank is really made to be straight on where you can't penetrate these plates. But at angles when he's pulling up, my first thought was I could shoot him here, but I wound up hitting him in the thin armor behind his drive wheel. So let's go back to that. Now here I have a long reload, 26 seconds. I'm just waiting to see what my next shot's going to be. Looking at the field out here, the enemy forces are advancing, my guys are retreating. So I think maybe, you know, the 705A will show up again. I can take a shot at him, but it doesn't appear to be the case. The M4 goes down. The 268 goes past, but I don't have a shot on him. In fact, he's actually behind other buildings. So then, right here, I see this 110E3 charging my 60 TP. He probably figures he's low on health, he can get a shot on him, they're losing the game, he's got to do something. So I rush forward and I take a shot. And he goes down. So now I'm kind of just taking cover and looking for my next move. I'm thinking about the 121B over here, or maybe this object 268. I start going in that direction, but then I realize they're surrounded by other forces. So I'm going to try to leave this pack early and get down here on this IS-4. Because there's other tanks that are faster than me, and if I don't leave now, I'll never get down here in time to get any shots on anyone. So I peek out. And for me now, this is just a race to get down here before all of these guys do while they're still distracted. I see the mouse coming up from behind the rail cars. I'm going to try to line up a shot. He sees me, immediately points at me, I take a shot. I try to get out of the way. Now I'm looking around, is anyone coming up behind me? No. So now I'm going to try to go around and try to get a side shot on the mouse. And I see there's a building and a wall, but then I see the IS-4 can't see me, doesn't know I'm here. He's got a red icon, which means he's like a new player. So I see that I have a shot on him. Take him out. And now as I'm reloading, I'm waiting for an opportunity. I see the EBR come up. He takes a shot at the mouse, and then artillery takes him out. And that's the game. So, simple game. Uncomplicated, 5,000 damage.